This is the energy vibration reading for the Gemini Sun, Moon, and Rising sign. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. This is the energy vibration reading for July 2018. For the month of July, we have the energy vibration of the Hierophant. And with the energy of the Hierophant, it is an organization. It's a group of people that you're going to be working out your karmatic situations with. What is going to transpire is that the Zodiac energies is going to be the energies of water in the two first weeks. And in the two last weeks, you are going to be having the energy of fire. Okay, now water and fire is not one of the most healthy thing, especially because you guys are having and working with the sign of hurt water and fire. For you guys, you have the energy of the world, you Gemini, so whatever is happening, you have the energy of the world. Now, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Welcome all new Geminis. I love you guys. You know, the energy of the world is something is ending and something beautiful, beautiful is coming in. I want to say to each and every person that this month is being dedicated to a subscriber who have sent us help and as you know, make it possible that we can have these new deck. This is a new deck that I'm sharing with each and every person. This is the first time I'm even opening the deck and using the deck. So let's say thanks to Sadie. And thank you for the wonderful support that you have been given to us via these decks of cards. So every time we use this deck, we're going to be saying thanks to Sadie and ask the universe to bless her for the wonderful gifts and things that she has been doing for this channel. Okay, so let's go in the month to see what you Geminis are going to have, because the energy is that things are going to be ending and new beginnings are going to be coming up. So let's see what is going to be coming out for you Geminis. The month had 4 weeks, so let's see. First week, we have the energy of the Five of Swords. Is it the Nine of Swords? Worries. Or is it the Five of Swords? The Five of Swords. There's going to be worries for some of you Geminis in the first week. So release yourself of the worries. And remember, when you guys have the energy of the Five of Swords, it's going to be that your thoughts, be aware of your thoughts, what you're giving out. Be aware of the conflicts. Stay away from conflicts in the first week. The second week, it's going to be the energy of the two. And let me put my glasses on. So the second week is going to be the energy of the Magician. So this is going to be good because it's going to be a positive week for you Geminis. So in the first week, whenever it comes on to if you are having any situation with the law, be careful, because there's a lot of conflicts or conflicts with people in the first week. Second week is going to be wonderful because you have the energy of the Magician, and the energy of the Magician is a wonderful positive energy because it's your energy vibration. So this is good. And I've seen this coming out for a lot of the air signs, that your own energy is coming out. Third week, wonderful energies. Third week, some of you have a situation with the Knight of Pentacles. And this Knight of Pentacles could be your boss, but it's someone that you have to be dealing with at work. It could be someone that you're applying for to a job with, that sort of a thing. So this Knight is going to be coming up in the third week. It can be someone who is a feminine, is also a man or a woman who is a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Okay, but the week is a week of passion, and it's a week of you connecting with others, and it could be a teacher or that sort of a thing, someone uh, It can be a tutor and that sort of a thing that is coming out, okay? Last week, you have the energy of the Six of Cups, so this is good. The last week is going to be connection with family. This is wonderful. It doesn't have to be your birth family, but people who you connect with can be people on the work floor, okay? So, as we look at this energy, and the month for you guys, it begins with conflicts, but you are going to be with your communication. You're going to receive help to get yourself out of this. And in the third week, you're going to be dealing with someone. It could be in a work situation or it could be in a group situation that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. This person is between the ages of 25 and 45. And some of you could be connecting with this person as a family member or someone who you have known from the past or from a past life. But you have the energy of hair. And the third week you have the energy of the pentacles. So it's not going to be a bad month because you have the energy of the world. And these are the situations and people and situations are coming in to help you. So, okay, let's build on the month and see what is going to happen. In the first week, going to the second week, we have the energy of the three of... Oh, isn't this beautiful? This is so beautiful. The Three of Cups, the Three of Cups, the Three of Love. Isn't this wonderful? It is so positive, so wonderful, so beautiful. It is the Three of Cups coming in. So this is a wonderful, positive energy. As we move on from the second week to the third week, we have the Ace of Pentacles. So this is wonderful. So a celebration is going to come in, and this is going to be extra money coming in because you have the energy of the Cups coming in. Then we have the energy of the Sun. Isn't this wonderful for you, Geminis? I told you. So for a lot of you who... was connected to a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. This could be a family member or someone from the past or an ex-lover coming in. It's going to be a fabulous, fabulous, fabulous week, month, because the energy of the Sun comes out. And what this is saying for a lot of you is that whatever the situation is between you and a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, it's going to be good. There is a connection that is coming in. As we look at the energy of the Three of Cups and the Ace of Pentacles, what is connecting that is the Four of the Lollies. This is beautiful. So what this is saying is that there is a stability that is coming in your life. There's basically a strong stability. You have the energy of the Magician, which is your energy vibration, and you're bringing in a celebration of love and stability and money. So if you're doing a new business, or if you are working hard, what we're seeing is that you're going to be receiving a promotion, and this promotion is going to bring you a lot of success. The Seven, the Chariot is here. This is a wonderful energy. The energy of the Chariot comes in as a victory and a success. So for some of you, and let's see what is the outcomes of this month. So it's a positive month for you, Geminis, because what we're seeing is positive. The Ace of Pentacles in the middle of the month is saying, I end my story. Isn't this a beautiful month? Oh yeah. Wow. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is a positive month. As I look, the beginning of the month, the first week, you have a situation where you're going to be celebrating a strong foundation. You're going to be celebrating overcoming a situation that has been in your life for some times that you have been dealing with. It's a positive outcome because what is happening is that you are coming out the star. You're coming out the star. The energy of the star is the energy vibration of your sister sign that is bringing you luck in your life. As we look at the situation with family, there is going to be an Elin coming in for a situation in the family, and you're going to be victoriously outcoming of the situation. So there is the energy of the sun, the star. So the energy of the Six of Cups has a connection with family. It has a connection with past life people that you have known that has come back in this lifetime in a positive way. And what is happening is that an Elin is coming in, and a victory and a successful outcomes is here. There is hope. There is new hope that is coming in for you, and this is going to be good. The outcomes and the most important thing of this month is the World with Ace of Pentacles is basically a positive situation that if there was financial situation, if you are going through financial struggles and that sort of a thing, that is going to be ending in this month, because the outcomes of the month is the Ace of Pentacles with the star, which mean that this is going to be a positive solution to whatever situation that is going on. Okay, so this is a wonderful situation and wonderful news. So some of you are going to be dealing with more Geminis and Aquarian. The Aquarians are going to be helping you out in this month. Then you are going to be dealing with the male or female between the ages of 25 and 45 of the Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and they are going to be helping you out of a situation. The Ace of Pentacles is here, and what that is doing is that you're trying to build on a strong financial situation, and you're going to be a success. You're going to be coming out victorious and successful, and this is going to be good. Okay, congrats, kudos to you. Okay, I'm using the other deck to see where the situation has transpired and what is coming out. So what I'm doing is a mirror of the month for you guys. So let's see what is coming out. In the past, you had a transition, a move, a transition. Some of you moved in the future. At the present, in the middle of the month, you're going to have friends coming in to help you. End of the month, you're going to receive a message, which is good. As we look on in the second week, there is the energy of a situation in the first week where there was some theft that went on. And then now you have a strong foundation. With that strong foundation comes your luck. Luck is coming in, and this is going to be good. And then in the third and fourth week, you have, and if you notice, all of the negative energies are actually in the past, in the first week where there was a conflict. And for you women, ladies out there, it's going to be in the middle of the month. For you ladies out there, you are going to have a strong foundation and stable. Conflicts is going to be coming, but this conflict is going to be coming in and over, and you're going to be very much successful. Okay, the men are going to be on the lookout. The men are going to be focusing on building their lives. They're going to be working very hard to connect and build their life. So as we reconnect with the energies, in the past, there was a move, and there was a lot of theft and a lot of deceitfulness that has happened in your life in the past. In the future, in the middle of the month, the second week and the third week, friends and people are going to be coming in to help you. And this could be the energy of the Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn people who we're going to be coming in to help you. You have a stability. Money is going to be coming in. So your financial situation is going to be balanced and stay balanced. It's as if money is coming in your life to stay in the month of July. There is a lot of sun around us. And with the energy of the sun, I'm going to show you what you have coming up. For the ladies, there were some very jealous people and deceitful people that was in the past. And now what is happening is that you're coming out as the star. So you ladies, you're going to be coming out as the star. So this is wonderful and positive. Now, this energy is for the men. For you men, there's going to be a lot of conflicts. You men are going to be in a lot of conflicts, a lot of quarrels, a lot of conflicts, chaotic situation, but they're going to be resolved. Okay, so wonderful outcomes. You have the energy of the sun that is portraying a positive news that is coming in. A positive news that is coming in. This news could be coming in from friends, but it could be also coming in from thing there. You are going to have a big win and a success. Luck is going to be coming to you. A big win and a success. Luck is going to be coming in for you. And then there is a conflict, and this conflict can for you men in your relationships, this conflict could be in your relationship that you found out something about your partner. And this is a situation that you're going to overcome, but you're going to find out something about your partner. And this is where the conflict is coming with. So if you have been in a relationship for a very long time, you are going to be finding out something about this person. You're going to either decide to move away from this relationship or stay in this relationship. Whatever your decision is in this relationship, it is your decision to decide whether or not you're going to stay or you're going to leave. Now, I should advise you men that a theft was done by someone over the age of 40 that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, okay? A theft was done by you men that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius over the age of 40. Some of you men could have a conflict with this person in the past of... this could be your father. Some of you men could have had a conflict with your father, and there was a lot of jealousy, obsession, and that sort of a thing. And that is what is happening in the past for you guys. Let's look and see what is the outcomes, the energy you have, because I'm using, this is another deck that was given to us by that supporter of our channel. And it says, make time for self-care. Taking care of yourself is essential right now. Taking care of yourself is essential right now. So this month is a month of self-care, taking care of yourself, making sure that you take care of you before you take care of anyone else. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to wish you a wonderful, positive month, and we're wishing you all the luck in the world. Namaste.